let's talk about what cooked means, especially in the context of a baked good. As you might be able to tell from other things we've done in this class, I'm going to tell you it's way complicated. Let's just go through a few of the processes that need to happen for something to go from raw to cooked. Well, part of the temperature increase is that it can sanitize what it is you're cooking, right? It's like pasteurization. The increased temperature over a sufficient duration will deactivate the microbes that might have been in the food. So that's important. We also know when we have starch in the food, we want to humidify that starch, turn it into a nice gel through gelatinization and make it digestible. So that's another thing that is generally happening with cooking. Also, we have some dehydration going on while we are cooking, especially if we aren't boiling the food. Hard to dehydrate things by boiling them, but if you are baking it in an oven or through another mechanism, some of the water that is in the food will leave by becoming steam as the temperature is elevated. We don't do this to the point where all water is gone in general, but usually we do it to the point where water is very significantly reduced in the outside edge, and that's what gives us crust. How do we know this? Well, the crust is brown, and that comes from the Maillard reaction, which only happens around 300 degrees Fahrenheit or higher, and at that point there isn't that much water remaining in the system. But you'll also know if you've ever tried to cook something till it's brown all the way through, that's not the water level we're shooting for consistently. It's just what we want on the surface. Another impact of dehydrating the food a little bit through cooking it in an oven is that it helps the material that makes up the bread or the cookie or the cracker transition from being more like a liquid to being more like a solid, because the solids are what's left behind as the water leaves the system. So that's part of it solidifying. And another final part of this whole interaction is that proteins that are present start to denature as we cook at high temperature. These proteins denature, and they can become, as they denature, they form different sorts of entanglements and bonds, which lead to the food having a greater interior structure. You can see this if you, for example, crack an egg and cook it by scrambling it or making an egg over easy. The proteins that were in the egg white and the egg yolk denature and go from being in solution to becoming basically a gel as they entangle with each other and trap some of the water that was initially present. So there you go. In cooking, we are gelatinizing starch. We are killing harmful microbes. We are removing water, which has several effects. And we are denaturing protein. All of these things together give us what we are accustomed to seeing in a baked good.